The chicken for the private room is ready.
Coming.
Hey, they need to pay some other tab for once.
Here, Mr. Wu, have some more.
Yeah, please, eat. Have more.
Here you go.
Okay, your chicken is ready.
Ms. Ding,
yes?
If you need something, just talk to Wu.
From He'll now help on, you. You can count on Mr.
Call
Wu.
Me if you ever need help.
Also, get two more packs.
All right.
Here, let's try that chicken.
Yeah.
Yeah, dig in.
Hey, Yan, come take these cigarettes in.
Okay.
Eat up, men. It's delicious.
Here. Cheers. Yeah.
The chicken was great.
Done eating?
All done.
Good day.
Thank you.
Mr. Wu, can you please settle your tab today?
Next time. We'll pay, don't worry.
But sir, it's just your tab is so high. At least pay some of it.
Sir, listen. We don't have the turnover to sustain this.
Just what are you saying, huh? You'll get paid next time. Didn't you hear?
We can't wait. We borrowed money to open the restaurant. We haven't paid it back. We can't even pay our workers their salaries. We get our liquor, cigarettes, and food on credit. If you don't pay your bill, we won't be able to remain open. Please, can't the party take care of us?
Mrs. Ding, you must be flexible when you deal with the government. That's the way to keep your business open. Don't you agree? Hmm?
We can't keep doing this. It's such an evil world. They eat, they drink, but these government scum never pay a cent. They're worse than bandits and robbers.
Oh, Mrs. Ding.
Hi.
I'm surprised you have time to see me.
I need a favor.
Oh.
We're a bit short at the restaurant and need to borrow more.
What?
We borrowed money to pay for this truck. I'm really sorry. We'd like to help, but we have to pay our loan back.
I just ordered more medicine, so money is very tight now. I'm really sorry, but I can't help.
It's fine.
Yesterday, the quality inspectors came. They claimed we're not up to standard, so they fined us. It's just outright tyranny.
Ruthen?
Yes?
Business is hard just now, and this is all that I have. But I want you to take it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Chief Ho, that was some luck last night. You want a
Cheers.
Lot?
Let's drink. Well.
Let's have another.
Great night.
Cheers.
Another round.
Uh-huh. Mr. Chen. Yes, of course. Not to
the
worry.
Bureau
we'll
chief.
Get the job done. Yeah.
So what's wrong?
What happened?
He wants the job done.
Damn.
They always do this around the holidays. The damn fine quotas get higher every year. The bosses sit in their office drinking tea, while we run around in a sweat doing all the work. And they give us the worst jobs. Every time.
Come on, don't be mad.
There's no point in complaining. If we don't finish it, we don't get a bonus. Not to mention promotions. Let's find a reason to give a fine. Come on.
Hey, stay.
We're leaving.
Let's dance. Till next time.
Here's your change. 2.5 yuan.
Here's the money.
Thanks.
Mr. Zhang, huh? You gave me too much.
I must be getting old and senile.
You saw 50 as a 10.
How much is it?
Yan, what's up? Yeah? Huh? based on just one call of complaint? You say we defraud customers by selling broiler chicken as free range? We'd never do something like that. Why did you freeze our business license?
Yeah, why?
We're just following the law.
Following the law?
You've accused us of a crime without any real proof. We can't accept this fine.
It's not up to us, so don't waste our time, okay? Pay your fine, and you'll get your license back. Take
it. If you have a problem, talk to the bureau chief.
What?
How much?
How could...
Last time you fined us $5,000. This time you want $18,000?
Please! You have to at least leave us enough to survive.
Stop. You shut up. Don't pay, we'll close you down.
Get out.
But
go on. Get moving.
What you're doing is blatant
robbery.
Where
do we
robbery.
Go?
Get out of here.
Is this how you serve the people?
Get out.
You watch your mouth. Keep it up. You'll be an obstruction. Now
you
go.
You can't. This is
go.
An outrage.
But...
Mama, the teacher said we have to pay tuition.
I know that.
If we don't pay, they won't let me go to school.
Pay, 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 that's all they ever want!
Mama, don't be angry. If you don't have the money, I just won't go to school.
Come, Lei. Go to your room, okay? Let's do your homework.
Don't yell at him for money we owe. I said we shouldn't own a restaurant. With the CCP, one can't run a business. You didn't believe me. You insisted on the restaurant. You said we needed it so Lei could go to college. How'd that turn out? Did we earn anything? The CCP runs China. There'll be no fairness while they rule. Every day it's deceit and blackmail. You couldn't see it, but I did all along.
I didn't think they'd be so evil. These corrupt officials. Sanitation, commerce, taxation, health. Every department takes bribes. If you can't pay, they find ways to frame you. Then they either fine you or close your business. They never pay any of their bills, and now there's 40 to 50,000 we'll never get back. All that we worked so hard for, sucked away clean by corrupt officials.
Roiland.
With the CCP in power, all officials are corrupt. Common people like us have no power. We have no choice but to be oppressed. Running a business and having a decent life in China is nothing but a dream.
Forget about a good life. The loans we took to open up the restaurant will take half our lives to pay off. China is an awful place. There's no way to live here.
Now you finally understand. This is the darkness we live in with the CCP. Ordinary people can't survive. I asked you to believe in God, but you didn't listen. You both insisted on doing this. And after all of that suffering, you earned nothing and have such large debts.
Had I known this would be the result, I'd have believed instead. At the time, I was worried about the CCP's persecution of religious faith. I thought if I were arrested, our lives would be even worse. I never thought a business would end up like this. Hello?
Hey, it's me.
Oh, hi.
Have you two made a decision about coming to work in Korea?
The agent fee alone is more than $100,000. Where will I get it? If we can't find work, we'll have spent a fortune on nothing.
Don't worry about it. I'll loan you the money for now. You can pay it back when you have it. Listen, you'd have to work years in China to earn what you make in 1 year here. I promise you won't regret coming to Korea.
If the money problem is solved, we're happy to go abroad. All right, it sounds like a plan. Okay. Hey, Mingyi. Yongshu says he'll loan us the money. Let's go to Korea. Korea is a democratic country. There's rule of law. There won't be corrupt officials blackmailing us. If we both get jobs in Korea and work for a few years, we'll be able to pay off our debts and save the money for Lei to go to college. In Korea, we could go to meetings and believe in God. What do you think?
Mama.
It's a good plan. But if we both go, what about your mother and Lei?
You don't need to worry about us. I'll care for Lei. Go and do what must be done.
Mama, call me when you're in Korea.
Hey, Mingyi.
Yeah?
Look here, the light is wonderful.
Not bad at all.
Hey, Rulin.
Yes?
How's the apartment? It looks all right.
It's great. Great. Here you go.
Hey, I need soy sauce. Bring me some.
Coming.
Here, your chicken.
There, casserole's ready.
Careful, it's hot.
Table six.
Got it. 38,000 yuan.
Okay, just a minute.
Hi, what can I get you?
Table seven, shredded pork.
Two more sheets.
Here, it's table ten's order. Preparing food isn't bad work. Let's do that.
Coming!
Pastries you made, they were very interesting. Maybe one day you can be our pastry chef.
Is that so?
Hey, you okay?
You all right?
I'm fine.
What's going on?
I'm very sorry. I'll pay more attention.
Be careful.
I will.
Everyone, keep the pace up.
Mr. Goh, you all right?
I'm all right. It's an old condition. Stand over 10 hours a day, you develop pains.
Mr. Guo, you should go get it looked at. You can't keep this up.
It's true.
You're pushing yourself like a robot.
Well, what can I do? I took out a high-interest loan to come with my son to Korea. But he just refuses to learn decent habits and spends more than he earns. The burden of the debt falls on me alone. I don't have the time to be sick. I'm like a donkey that's tied to a millstone. I can only keep going. I can't go back.
Mr. Guo, don't be so pessimistic.
No, here's what I think.
It's true that things are hard and tiring for us right now, but after a few years, things will change. I won't lie. Next month, I'm going to Busan to help a friend with his restaurant.
So you made the decision?
Yeah. And I made up my mind. Once I save enough, I'll open my own restaurant. Then I'll be the boss. People need to have a clear vision. Look past the here and now. Mm. Isn't that right?
Indeed. We may suffer now, but as they say, if you want to appear dignified when people are looking, you have to suffer when they aren't. Once we've saved enough, we'll be our own bosses too. What's bitter will in time turn sweet.
Yeah. That's the idea.
Yes, but now, let's drink.
Mingyi, will you rub my back? Mingyi.
Yeah?
Shiksaseo.
What's that mean?
Meal time.
Wow, your Korean is getting really good. Hello, Mr. Yang. As soon as we can.
What was that?
His son is getting married. They need to buy a house. He wants us to pay him back. How much do we have left?
Just over 20,000.
Over 20,000. Let's pay back 20,000.
Okay. Youngju found me part-time cleaning work.
The owner's a germaphobe and very picky, but the pay is good. Do you think I should take the job?
If you work 12 hours a day, then do house cleaning, will your body be able to handle it?
It will. Let's pay it back as soon as we can, since we owe so much. Then our unease will stop.
Yuan, Yuan, did you drink your milk?
Yeah.
Mrs. Ding, yes? Come here, look at this. This does not look clean to me. Look, here, here, here. Can't you do your job?
I'm sorry, I'll clean it again right now.
Ugh. You know we're busy, yet you're so late. Hey, hi, Lei.
Mama, look, I got first prize in the art contest.
Really? I'm so proud.
My teacher said that I should take classes and then enter the city contest.
My love, as long as you work hard, I'll support you with whatever you want, okay?
Ask Mom if she's tired.
Mama, are you tired?
No. No, I'm not, okay? My love,
mm-hmm.
You be a good boy for Grandma.
Miss Ding, okay? Come here for a minute.
My love, work is busy, so I have to go. But I can call you tonight.
Okay.
Okay?
We need to find time to get that looked at. Medicine isn't enough for this.
It's fine. It's just a small issue. I'm so busy every day. I live for money. And my heart always feels empty. Is this really all there is to life? And yet, I keep thinking, if we had faith, our lives would be better.
Once we're out of debt, we can pursue faith in God.
But can we continue existing like this? we really should think about belief in God. Maybe it will help with the emptiness we feel. Let's find someone and seek answers.
All right. You go ahead and seek.
Hello there.
Hello to
Hello
you.
Hello there.
We're from the Church of Almighty God.
Take a look at this brochure.
Ding Rulin?
Lin Jishin?
It's really you!
Indeed. You two know each other?
We went to high school together.
The last few years, I ran a restaurant in China. I thought I could make some money. I didn't know of all the demands that the government officials from every department would make. They dined without paying and had run up a tab of tens of thousands. Not only did I make nothing, I fell into deep debt. With the CCP in power, ordinary people can't survive.
True.
Our debts from the restaurant were too high. We had no options, so we came to Korea to get jobs. Now that we're here, things are much better. So, tell me, how long have you been in Korea?
I've been here 7 or 8 years. Life in a real democracy is so much better than CCP rule. At the very least, there are no officials who try to blackmail you or eat for free. You also don't need to pay out endless bribes. Doing business here is easier.
I was right to come to Korea, especially because you're here. It's wonderful to see a friend in a foreign country full of strangers. Hey, may I ask, when did you start believing in God?
5 years ago?
I wanted to believe back on the mainland.
Really?
But seeing the CCP widely persecute all religious faiths and arrest Christians, I didn't dare believe. I thought that if I were to start a business and save enough for my child to go to college, it wouldn't be too late to believe in God later. But now, here in Korea, I could believe while I work. Wouldn't that be just great?
Of course that would. When people live in this world, if they don't grasp truth, no matter what, they will feel miserable. Those in power who have wealth feel empty. When we lack power and are robbed and oppressed, we're even more miserable and empty. That is why life, without believing, is to live a life in vain. That ends with dying still confused. Isn't that a shame?
You're completely right. In the years I've been in business, I've endured so much deceit. I've tasted despotism's bitterness, and it's felt like death is better. But there can't be contentment in death. I've been thinking, just what is true happiness? How can I live so that I feel true happiness? I haven't figured it out. My friend, you believe in God. Would you speak with me? Why do you believe in God? What does your faith bring you? That's what I want to know.
Faith brings many good things. Putting it simply, people must grasp why they live. A life in confusion is worthless. Why should we believe in God? Because mankind was created by God. Our lifespans and fate, illnesses and death, happiness, are all in God's hands. People often say, as people act, heaven watches. Man proposes, God disposes. If what we say and do, if our path aligns with God's will, we'll gain God's blessings. If we follow Him, we gain God's protection, and our lives will be peaceful and joyous. Why is our world so dark and evil, and why are people so corrupt? People can't provide clear answers. God saves mankind and explains these matters clearly. Without belief in God, we cannot grasp the truth and we cannot walk the path of life. In the years I've believed, I've read a lot of God's word. I've understood the truth about life. I've learned of the root of darkness in the world. And I've come to grasp that people are evil because Satan has corrupted mankind. I have come to know just what kind of people hold power, why people's lives are empty and miserable, as well as the cause. Where people came from, where they are going, God's will in creating people, what kinds of people God saves and curses, where people's endings can be found, and so much more. I grasp the truths of these mysteries, and my heart is ever so much brighter. I know how to live to find peace and joy, and how to live to gain God's blessing. In this dark world of ours, only Christ is the truth, the way, and the life. When the Lord Jesus appeared, he said, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." Now the Lord Jesus has returned, and the kingdom of heaven has come to earth. If we believe in God and follow him, we'll gain the truth as life. Then we can enter the kingdom of heaven, a beautiful destination. This is such a great blessing. Those who don't believe, they can only live in sin. And then, when the great disaster comes, they'll fall directly to hell. The kingdom of heaven has now come. So what will you choose?
I didn't know that faith lets you see things so clearly. I'm so happy I could meet with you and discuss belief in God. I would love to hear more of your thoughts.
Of course. I know this isn't an easy thing. How's this? First, I'll show you two videos of readings of God's word.
Yes, all right.